Ladies and gentlemen, we are set to go with the Friday night fight featured bout of the evening. It's all being brought to you by Chung Beer, Amazing Thailand, Scratch DJ Academy, Fitness Nutritional Counseling, Lucky Strike, Adidas Combat Sports, and the Mohegan Sun Resort and Casino. This bout is sanctioned by the WKA, President in Attendance, Brian Crenshaw. Your referee for this contest is Chris the Cannon Wagner. And now, ladies and gentlemen, five rounds of professional Muay Thai scheduled in the 155-pound weight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, professional record, 34 victories, 17 defeats, 3 draws. He weighed in at an even 154 pounds. He represents Stay Fly Muay Thai from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Ladies and gentlemen, Justin, the Purple People Eater, Greskiewicz. Greskiewicz. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner. He wears the black with blue trim. He weighed in at 158.3 pounds. His professional record, 11 victories against only one defeat. He has one draw, representing Anderson's Martial Arts from New York City. Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Black Panther Lukusa. Lukusa.
We are a few moments away from our main event of the evening. The Purple People Eater, Justin Greskiewicz out of Philadelphia, seasoned professional, performing his Y crew right now. And that will delay the proceedings just a bit. The traditional Muay Thai performance before fighters actually enter battle.
Yeah, it's used for many reasons. It's used for concentration. It's also used for a level of spirituality to show respect to your teacher, to your ancestors, to your family. Everything is done in succession of three. And it was also used back then, you know, to tell your lineage, because if you had a similar Y crew to your opponent, it might mean that you came from the same lineage and then they wouldn't fight. So there's a lot of history behind the Y crew. And it also is an excellent warm-up. Like, if you look at it from a biomechanical perspective, it's warming up your hips, your shoulders, it's helping with your kicks. Very beautiful art. Really always paying respect and homage to your teacher. Y meaning respect, and then or bowing or respect, a sign of respect. And then crew, of course, meaning teacher.
And just another layer of intrigue added to this main event bout between Chris Lukusa and Justin Greskiewicz. Yesterday, we were expecting both men to come in at the agreed upon 155 pounds, but Lukusa came in way heavy. 12 pounds.
Wow.
Over 155. He came in at 167, was able to cut down to 158, and Greskiewicz agreed to fight because Greskiewicz actually walks around at about 155 anyway.
Yeah.
So he didn't have any issue making weight. Lukusa, meanwhile, came in much heavier. And this is also Lukusa's first fight with his new school, his new trainer, Dan Anderson and Anderson Martial Arts. Previously, he was with Squared Circle. Now he trains with Anderson's. He's got a new nickname, used to be known as Super Swiss. Now he goes by the Black Panther. And he's got to wait an extra 5 or so minutes to get to action with Justin Greskiewicz, who's performing his Y crew. And Greskiewicz, out of Philadelphia, owns and operates. He's the head coach of Stay Fly Muay Thai. Chris the Cannon Wagner tells the Purple People Eater, let's go. And here we go. 5 3-minute rounds in our co-main event, our final bout of the evening, our final fight of 2016 on Friday Night Fights, presented by Chong Beer. And here we go. Chris Lukusa and Justin Greskiewicz.
Now, there are these are modified rules, so one of the major weapons that Justin is very good at is his elbows, and those were taken away from this fight. They are fighting at modified rules.
Lukusa also likes to employ the elbow attacks, so that comes out of his repertoire as well.
Lukusa has a very more Dutch style. He likes to throw those leg kicks. He keeps a very tight guard. He shells up. Greskiewicz, you know, has been known to be somewhat of a slow starter, but he is always very dangerous. He's a very game fighter. One thing about Greskiewicz that I can say is that he is fearless. He has fought some of the best in the business. Malapet, I mean,
Lukusa goes low on the Purple People Eater. That did not look like it felt particularly good.
Yeah, he saw Justin just kind of take a knee immediately.
Now I'm wondering, Phoenix, a couple months ago, back in August, right here at, it might have been a lucky strike, as a matter of fact, Elvis Gashi, who only fights Glory Rules fights, at least as far as we know in the professional ranks, he fights in Glory Rules. At the end of his fight, you asked him, who do you want next? And he said he wants Lukusa.
Yeah, because of both of their styles, he think would match up well. I'm hoping to see that fight sometime next year.
And I just find it interesting that, not saying there's anything related to it, but that Lukusa's fighting a fight with no elbows allowed right now. And that's usually how Gashi fights, so I wonder if he's
himself to delete that from his arsenal so that he can go into that bout prepared. I see your theory there.
Well, conspiracy theory. It might not be on target, but I like to be play detective sometimes.
Well, right now he's fighting the Purple People Eater, and he just hit him with a left hook.
Lukusa in the black and blue trunks. Greskiewicz ducks out of the way of further attack. Greskiewicz wearing the white and black with purple on the front, and of course sporting the purple hair.
Now again, Justin is a slow starter. It takes him a little bit of time to figure his opponents out, and then he finds a weakness and he really goes for it. He does have knockout power. He is a very, very smart fighter, and he is very dedicated to the art of Muay Thai.
Chris Wagner, our referee, getting a little frustrated with the mutual exchange of low blows. Big right hand from Lukusa sends Greskiewicz flying.
Lukusa really unloading his hands here. Big jab that lands straight through the middle, followed by a right. They're clinching up. You see the power on Lukusa. He lands a nice short uppercut in the middle. He's going around Greskiewicz's guard. Dan Anderson calling for Lukusa to continue to push forward.
Lukusa showing impressive hand speed. Tries to come in with the overhand right. Greskiewicz escapes. But only for a moment, Lukusa right on top of him. Chris Wagner will break up the two fighters. Greskiewicz, a seasoned pro, as we hit the 10-second mark in round number one. Lukusa trying to wail away in the corner. And there's the bell. So a funky halt, stopping and starting, a halting round one to begin our co-main event, our final fight of 2016 on Friday Night Fights, Chris Lukusa and Justin Greskiewicz. Now Greskiewicz, a seasoned pro, comes in with a record of 34-17-3 in the pro ranks. Also fought a couple of MMA bouts and says, including his amateur career, he's fought 81 fights in his career.
Yeah, I can believe that. I've seen several of them.
Lukusa, meanwhile, sporting a pro record of 11-1-1. And that one came back in April at Lucky Strike Manhattan when Lukusa fought to a five-round draw against Pavel Zavistowski. That's the only draw on Lukusa's record. So two game fighters here, two experienced professionals in the squared circle to close out 2016. Here we go with round number two of a scheduled five. All three-minute rounds, of course, in the pro ranks. 155-pound weight class, though Lukusa came in just a bit heavier than that. Big right hand.
Nice overhand right. Looked like Greskiewicz wanted to clinch there. Lukusa's just kind of stopping him by powering through. Now it becomes a slugfest. Big knee. Lukusa making Greskiewicz just uncomfortable.
As Phoenix mentioned earlier, modified rules, professional bout, no elbows allowed.
That stiff left jab by Lukusa.
Lukusa has been scoring with those gloves through the first round and change so far. Pigs. Whoa. Lukusa out of control there. Swing and miss with the right hand, Phoenix, and he went tumbling into the corner.
Nice uppercut.
Greskiewicz tried to get something going with the leg kick, but Lukusa just steamrolled right through it.
No matter what happens, though, Greskiewicz always maintains his composure.
One of the brajads, one of the armbands of Justin Greskiewicz comes off, so he just sweeps it right out of the ring behind him.
Yeah.
And another glancing low blow thrown by Lukusa. Again, Chris Wagner will instruct the fighters to not do that. Easier said than done, I suppose.
Yeah, you know, you're going for those inside burn kicks. Nice leg kick by Greskiewicz. One of the things I admire about Greskiewicz, too, is that he does throw his kicks. Big kick by Lukusa. You heard that?
Thudding
right to
body
the body.
Kick. Helter-skelter fight so far between Greskiewicz and Lukusa. Final 30 seconds in round two.
Yeah, when Greskiewicz throws that leg kick, he angles himself off. That's one of the beauty of those leg kicks, is he's not kicking at his opponent, he's kicking through. So when he does throw those kicks, they really, really do like internal damage. You're getting that full bone on the medial part of the thigh. It's very painful.
Round two winding down. Lukusa lunging forward. Tries to catch Greskiewicz with a tee, but ends up maybe going low again as round two comes to an end. Well, an interesting and entertaining fight thus far. The final one we will have in 2016 on Friday Night Fights, brought to you by Chang Beer. Let's give a quick shout out to our other sponsors. Of course, Lucky Strike Manhattan, Mohegan Sun, Fitness NYC, Brooklyn Athletic Club, the Tourism Authority of Thailand, Scratch Academy of New York, and Adidas Combat Sports. Title sponsor, of course, is Chang Beer. And our friends at Q-Live Sports bringing us all the action from the Broad Street Ballroom in New York City. Quick hello to our Mr. Everything tonight, Freddie Sobranis, who's basically playing the role of producer, director, and technical director with Eric Brody and Pete Frelich on the road. Of course, also hello to Mark Beckerman, Kevin Talbot, and Victoria Harrington, our esteemed camera crew. Round three of a scheduled five set to begin, and here we go. Greskiewicz in the white and black with the purple hair. Chris Lukusa in the black and blue trunks. And Lukusa came in heavy at yesterday's weigh-in. He was able to burn off enough as he takes an inside leg kick and goes down right there.
Yeah, Greskiewicz was great at angling out and just kind of doing damage to the legs.
Huge abrasion on the back, upper, the mid-back to the, or more the oblique area of Greskiewicz, I think, from where Lukusa landed that big body kick.
Yeah, he's just a very powerful guy.
Originally from the Congo, grew up in Switzerland.
Well, Greskiewicz is seeing that Lukusa loads up his punches and gets really heavy on his legs, so he's taking advantage of that, and he's really trying to cut his kicks down.
Chris Wagner warning Lukusa against, I think, the use of those elbows, maybe, their forearms.
Did he?
Well, it seemed like he was gesturing towards the forearm area of Lukusa.
Yeah, I didn't see him throw an elbow, though, but it from
maybe
my angle,
maybe pushing with
I
the forearm,
yeah.
Perhaps? Remember, this is a modified rules professional bout. Elbows not being employed in this one. Lukusa down in his corner. Looks a little bit hurt. Had to pull the muscle.
As Greskiewicz sees him limping on his legs, he's going to continue to attack on his legs, but his leg is hurt. I don't know if it was his knee or it was actually hurt from all of those leg kicks. Like I said, Justin's leg kicks are just very damaging.
We'll see. This could turn the tide in a significant
way. Oh, big uppercut.
But Lukusa responds despite the apparent injury. Fires a nasty uppercut through the guard of Greskiewicz.
Big right hand there also by Lukusa. Lukusa just kind of stalking, hunting down. Greskiewicz just keeping his eyes wide open.
Good combo over the top from Lukusa. Again, rolling right through the leg kick of Greskiewicz.
That laser-like focus from both fighters. We don't know if Lukusa's legs are hurt because he has stopped using his kicks.
Good right
hand. Right hand snaps Gretzman's head back.
Looping right hand lands for Lukusa as round three comes to a close. And now it looks like Lukusa, at least the last minute or so of round number three, basically becoming an all-hands fighter.
January 20th, right back here at the Broad Street Ballroom.
Ariel Agami alongside Phoenix Carnevale for our Friday Night Fights finale in 2016 from the Broad Street Ballroom. It's our main event of the evening, Chris Lukusa, now fighting out of Anderson's Martial Arts, was previously with Squared Circle New York. This is his first fight, his first pro fight under Dan Anderson. And he's looking to score a win over the very, very experienced Justin Greskiewicz from Philadelphia.
Yeah, Dan Anderson has very nice things to say about Chris Lukusa. You know, he's an excellent teammate. He's a pleasure to work with. He's a really has an open mind to martial arts and to fighting, and you know, I think that they've been a good matchup so far.
Round four underway. Scheduled five. From the professional ranks, Chris Lukusa and Justin Greskiewicz. Lukusa seems to have recovered from whatever was ailing his leg in the third round. Seems to be moving a lot better.
Yeah. Oh, man. Greskiewicz's leg kicks are just really, really just chop you down.
And he's almost kicking towards the ankle area, Greskiewicz. He's going very low, trying to not only injure Lukusa's legs, but just sweep him out altogether.
Yeah, it's called a cut kick. It really is a very damaging. Causes the blood flow right to that area, will tighten your calves up. It's very, very uncomfortable.
And that could well have been what we saw Lukusa dealing with in the third round.
I don't know if it was that or like he hurt his knee. It was something. He just went down really quickly.
A little bit off balance on that. Swing and a miss with the right hand.
You can see a mouse starting to develop under the left eye of Justin Greskiewicz, kind of closing his eye up a little bit. Lukusa will try to take advantage of that. It's good to hit somebody while they're blinking, while their attention is a little bit off.
Body kick stopped by Lukusa, then dumps the purple people eater right onto the canvas.
That is a lot to say in one sentence.
A lot of tongue twisters tonight.
Looks like Lukusa wants to kick. You can see him shaking his right leg a little bit, but he's not utilizing it. Loads up that right hand.
Past the halfway mark of round number four. In our main event, Lukusa and Greskiewicz going at it.
Yeah. Oh, a head kick.
That got Lukusa's attention, to say the least.
It did. He did not look happy about that. Lukusa's starting to check those kicks now. Tries to corner Greskiewicz. Dan Anderson screaming for a 1-2 from the corner. Another 1-2. 1-2 lands. Double jab lands.
Lukusa's starting to find a home here with the gloves. Greskiewicz escapes the corner, still somewhat close to the ropes. Now he's backed up again.
Yeah, that big right hand snapped at Justin's head back. But we know that Greskiewicz does have a chin. I mean, you know, he's very durable, and he's always dangerous. No matter how many times you hit him, you always got to look out for him.
We are through four of a scheduled five. Lukusa unable to put Greskiewicz away to this point. Purple People Eater still hanging around. The feisty veteran. 81 fights combined between his amateur and pro career in Muay Thai and MMA together. Lukusa participating in his 14th professional bout. A lot of mileage on Justin Greskiewicz coming into this fight. He's in there tough against Chris Lukusa. And we're not sure what Lukusa rehydrated to coming into today's action, but you got to figure he's got a few more pounds of meat on him than does Greskiewicz.
Than he did yesterday, yeah. He's definitely a muscular guy. I don't know what the problem was with him making weight. I don't know what the story is behind that.
Here we go, our last round of the year. We're expecting some fireworks between Lukusa
and
Greskiewicz.
This is the fifth and final round.
All right. We're going to end the year off right here at Friday Night Fights, the fifth and final round. Greskiewicz with a nice left hook. Lukusa with a big 1-2. Tripling up on that jab.
Lukusa trying to put the finishing touches on another excellent performance as his left hand rocks Greskiewicz back towards the ropes. Big right hand from Lukusa. And the right hand lands on the chin of Greskiewicz even as Lukusa takes a spill.
Greskiewicz also rolls a little bit with his punches as well, so they don't do as much damage as they look. But when he does get hit straight down the middle a lot also. So some of those punches to the side, you know, you see him parry him or he'll roll his head a little bit out of the way. So he's not taking that much on the chin. But there's been a few times that Lukusa has snapped his head back clean, fully.
Wild left from Lukusa.
What's bad about rolling with the punches, though, especially in Muay Thai as opposed to boxing, is that they score. Nice leg kick.
Greskiewicz attacks the outer thigh of Lukusa, who answers in kind and then fires a straight right. Greskiewicz got a shot in there. Again, Lukusa punching with so much ferocity that he slips to one knee.
Nice stiff jab by Greskiewicz as Lukusa was coming in. That was a slip. He ate a little bit of a right hand on the way down, but it was a slip.
Final 30 seconds of the evening. Round five coming to a close. Lukusa and Greskiewicz. Look like they are heading towards a decision unless one of them can close the show in a hurry.
Big leg kick that lands by Justin Greskiewicz. He's done a lot of damage to Lukusa's legs. Errol Arid is again.
Final 10 seconds of the season. Lukusa and Greskiewicz head to head.
Oh, big knee. Woo!
And that is it.
We shall see.
Fight has come to a close. Chris Lukusa looks for professional win number 12. Justin Greskiewicz looks for pro victory number 35. And it will be in the hands of the judges once again. So, Phoenix, as we await the decision between Lukusa and Greskiewicz, what would be your evaluation of what we saw in these five rounds?
It's really hard to say because, like I said, Greskiewicz rolls with the punches, so they don't do as much damage as you think. But he did take a few very hard punches, but he also delivered a lot more leg kicks and a lot more kicks than Lukusa did the entire fight. I would give maybe the earlier rounds to Lukusa and the later rounds to Greskiewicz. Did drop Lukusa. I think he dropped Lukusa with a leg kick. I'm not sure if that's what happened. Because, again, it looked like it was a bit of an injury, but, could have been injuries due to the fact that he had kicked out his legs, the entire fight. It's a hard one to call.
So Lukusa and Greskiewicz complete the final bout on Friday Night Fights in 2016. Let's find out who the winner is from David Diamante.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of action here in the Broad Street Ballroom, we go to the judges' score totals. Judge A, 50-45. Judges B and C, 49-46. All for your winner by unanimous decision, Chris Black Panther Lukusa.
Well, Chris Lukusa, now known as the Black Panther, comes away victorious as we close out 2016 in style. Phoenix, tremendous night of action from the Broad Street Ballroom. Your takeaways from this evening's action.
Man, it was really, sometimes you watch fight cards and you're like, oh, well, people kind of like lose throughout the fight. Everybody was game. Everybody had that fighter spirit. Everybody went out with a bang, took out 2016 with a bang, for sure.
Absolutely right, Phoenix. And that about does it for us here on Friday Night Fights, which, of course, is brought to you by Chang Beer. A big thank you to the good folks at the Broad Street Ballroom for hosting this exciting event. And our excellent sponsors as well. In addition to Chang Beer, Adidas, Mohegan Sun, Tourism Authority of Thailand, FitMiss NYC, Scratch Academy of New York, and the Brooklyn Athletic Club. Thanks to all of our fans in attendance, our viewers on social media and YouTube, where you can search and watch Friday Night Fights.
Have a good night, everybody.
Thank you very much, Phoenix Carnevale, my broadcast partner. Want to say send our best to the president of Friday Night Fights, Justin Blair, operations director Eddie Marini, our coordinator Lauren Gilbert, and our Q Live Sports team tonight consisting of Freddie Sobranis, Victoria Harrington, Kevin Talbot, and Mark Beckerman. For Phoenix Carnevale, my name is Ari Alagami. Have a great, happy, and healthy holiday season, everybody. We will see you once again on Friday Night Fights in 2017.